Have you ever wondered what is different from an artistic bike compared to a normal bike? This is what I will explain in this video. At first sight, the bike looks different because of the different shaped saddle, the different shaped handlebars, and the more compact geometry. Just like the frame itself, the handlebars are formed from a steel tube. The shape is similar to an upside down racing bike handlebar. The end of the handlebar must be rounded off or closed by grips. This shape offers the cyclist a larger area to stand on, but also sit between the handlebars. The saddle piston and the base are made of aluminium. The saddle cover is made of leather. This shape offers us as artistic cyclists a larger area to stand on or to sit in there and perform different wheelie positions. The frame is handmade from seamless, drawn precision steel tubes. The frame has an optimized geometry with short rear triangle and a steep fork. On my artistic bike, I have a synchroflex tooth belt. Not all artistic bikes have a belt, some others also have a chain, but I prefer the belt. The advantages of a belt is that a tooth belt, once adjusted, does not have to be retightened. The position of the rear wheel remains the same, even when removing or mounting the wheel. So the tedious readjustments of the chain tension after dismounting the rear wheel is no longer necessary. Also, the regular change of chain and sprockets is not necessary with the tooth belt. Both belt and pulley are still functional after years and therefore durable. In contrast to a chain, a synchronous belt does not require oil. It is always flexible without leaving stains on hands or shoes. At the same time, it is more comfortable to step on a flat, wide belt than on a chain. Tooth belt drive runs more smoothly and silently. There's no inherent vibration of the chain when riding fast, no rattling is transmitted to the frame. The rolling therefore reminds more of sliding. Also, the friction from the belt to the pulley is much lower here than from the chain to the chain ring. Less friction also means that the swing lasts much longer with the tooth belt drive than with a normal chain drive. In summary, a tooth belt is clean, quiet, maintenance-free and durable. But there are also disadvantages about the belt. For the belt, a frame lock is required for mounting the belt. Some people say this would be a predetermined break point of the frame, but I have been riding this bike since 2015 and I have had no problems whatsoever. The pulley is an aluminium synchronizing pulley with 40 teeth. The crank is CNC milled, it's made of aluminium, it is a high strength material with 130 mm of crank length. Maybe you know from my Instagram post that I have an outdoor bike but also an indoor bike. The main difference between those bikes are just the rim and the tires. The rim on my indoor bike is a double eyelet aluminium hollow chamber rim for tubular tires or tubeless tires. My outdoor bike is an aluminium hollow chamber rim for outdoor tires. From the BMX world, you maybe know them as pegs. We in Germany or in artistic cycling say Dornen to it, or in English, foot support. So we are allowed to equip the axis of both wheels on both sides with the foot supports, or as we call it, Dornen. It helps us to stand on it and to perform some different tricks. There are three main brands in artistic cycling for artistic bikes. I prefer to have the brand Langenberg bike, as you can read here. The most advantage about this brand is that they have the belt, as I shown you in this video, but there are also other brands, for example, Star Bicycle. They also do their frame out of aluminium, and there's also a brand which is called Valter. There are also some other brands, I think there's one in Japan or something like that, but these are the three main brands for artistic bikes. These were the technical specifics of an artistic bike. If you want to know about an artistic bike or about the sport itself, then write it to me in the comments. If you want to know more about me or want to watch some more videos of my bike tricks, then make sure to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.